Hello friends, welcome to GT Science tutorial. In this video, I'm going to explain about the nitrines. Nitrines are another type of reactive intermediate that are formed during the course of reaction. And these are very highly energized as well. So in this video, we are going to see what nitrines actually are, its types and generation as well as reactions of nitrines. So let's start. First of all, we need to understand what nitrines actually are. Nitrines are the nitrogen analog of carbene. That means nitrines and carbenes are very close to each other. A species having the general formula Rn and two pair of electrons are called nitrines. So if you think that in carbene, the structure of carbene is this is how we write carbene. In carbene there are only two electrons, but in nitrines there are four electrons. So how are they very close to each other? If you see ammonia, a very simple compound of nitrogen, this is how we write ammonia. In this particular case, what do we see? Nitrogen has made three bond with hydrogen and a lone pair of electron is with nitrogen. That means nitrogen always keeps a lone pair of electron with itself. That does not take part in a chemical reaction and it does not have any value for this kind of condition. Okay, so here nitrogen has two electrons over here, a lone pair of electron, that is these two electrons. Now these two electrons are the active part. Okay, they will make it a nitrine. So nitrine can be written as Rn. Here it has a lone pair of electron, that is unshared. Here also it has a lone pair of electron, that is unshared. Okay, now one more thing that you can notice from here nitrogen has only six electron, 1 2 3 4 5 6. So nitrogen has only six electrons over here and it needs only two electrons to be in octet states. That way, that means nitrines are electron deficient. That means it needs electron and they are highly reactive because of that, highly reactive as well. So nitrines are electron deficient and they are highly reactive. The reason for that is here nitrogen has only six electrons around it and it needs two more electrons in order to get in octet state. Okay, so this is what we call a nitrine. And here you can see that these two are little bit similar. That's why nitrines are also referred to as azocarbene. Sometimes nitrines are also called azocarbene. So you might find some book in which azocarbene might be written. So that doesn't mean that azocarbene is carbene. Azocarbene means nitrines. So you have to be very careful regarding that. Now let's see the types of nitrines. Just like carbenes, there are two types of nitrines as well. They are, the first one is singlet nitrine and the second one is triplet nitrine. Singlet nitrine and triplet nitrine. Singlet nitrines are those nitrines in which the unshared electrons are paired. So unshared electrons are paired in case of singlet nitrines. And here unshared electrons are not paired in case of triplet nitrines. So it can be written like this, Rn, like this, and this can be written as Rn, like this. Here these are the unshared electrons that make it a reactive intermediate, and these are paired, these are together over here, that's why they are called singlet nitrene. And here in this particular case, the two unshared electrons are not together, they are not together and they are not paired as well, that's why they are called the triplet nitrines. This can be also written as Rn, and one electron over here, one electron over here. So these are together, these are paired, so this is also singlet nitrine. And triplet nitrine can also be written as Rn, one electron over here, another electron over here. They are not paired, okay, they are not together. So these are the types of nitrines, these are similar to types of carbenes as well. Now let's see the generation of nitrines. There are many chemical reactions in which nitrines are formed. Few of them we are going to see today. The first reaction is alpha elimination reaction. Alpha elimination reaction. Generally, nitrines are formed in Hoffmann bromamide reaction. RC double bond O, NHBr. This compound, when reacts with a base, it forms nitrine. Now, how does this happen? There is a negative charge. This will abstract this proton, and there will be water that will be a byproduct. Similarly, when it gets the proton, so this bond will be broken. This electron pair will come over here, and this bond will be broken at the same time. So we finally get RC double bond O and two electrons. Two electrons, this is a normal two electron, and these electrons that it got from the bond breaking, okay, plus Br minus. So we get this nitrine. This is a nitrine, we know that, right? Because there are two electrons on nitrine that are unshared electrons, and nitrine has only one bond with a group. So these are called nitrines, okay. Similarly, there is another reaction as well in which alkyl azide converts into nitrine. So alkyl azide converts into nitrine when it is heated. So simply this is a thermal reaction. Alkyl azide has the general formula like this. This is alkyl azide. There should be a negative charge, there should be a positive charge, and there should be a lone pair like this. Now, what actually happens in this reaction? This negative charge will come over here. It will form a triple bond over here. Because of that, this bond will also break, and two electrons will come over here. This bond will also break, and two electrons will come over here. It will be better if we show like this. This bonding come here and this bond coming here. So we form R, and there is already a lone pair of electron. Now this bond will come here as a lone pair of electron. This formed a nitrine, and this will form nitrogen gas, because we know that N triple bond N means nitrogen gas, right? So this is nitrine. So in this reaction as well, nitrine have been formed. In this reaction as well, nitrines are formed. Now let's see the fate of nitrines, that means few of the reactions that nitrines undergo. Among many reactions, one of the most important reactions shown by nitrine is addition to double bond, that means carbon-carbon double bond. When there is carbon-carbon double bond, then nitrines react there and they form different compounds. So when nitrines react with carbon-carbon double bond, a cyclic structure is formed. Cyclic structure is formed. cyclic structure is formed. You can see over here, C double bond C, and there will be H2. If nitrene reacts with if nitrene reacts with a carbon-carbon double bond, then a cyclic structure is formed. Cyclic structure simply can be, this bond will be broken and this one electron will react with this carbon. This one electron will react with this carbon. So we will get a compound like this. This is N, this is N, R. So this is a cyclic compound that we get. This is a cyclic compound that we get when double bond is carbon-carbon double bond reacts with a nitrene. Now, we know that there are two types of nitrene. So obviously they will form different product as well. So singlet nitrenes are stereospecific. Singlet nitrenes are the stereospecific. The meaning of stereospecific is the cis will form cis and trans will form trans. That means the compound having cis geometrical isomerism forms cis product, and the compound having trans geometrical isomerism form trans product. You can see over here, let me write this part. We will see this reaction over here. Okay, like, let's take a compound C double bond C, H, R, R. This is a cis compound, right? Cis compound. Now, when it reacts with a nitrene, R and double electron, then it will always form a cis product. CC and this NR, RR, HH. So, this is a cis product. If it was a trans product means if this R was over here, then here the R would be over here. That means cis compound will form cis product and trans compound will form a trans product when singlet carbene reacts with it. But triplet carbenes do not actually form similar type of product. Triplet carbenes are non-stereospecific. That means it will form both cis and trans product. Whatever we take, whether we take a cis compound or a trans compound, we will get both of them, cis as well as trans product in the reaction. That means it will be like this, R H. This is a cis compound, right? This is a cis compound. When it reacts with a nitrene, so it will form a cis product like this. N R H and a trans product like this, N R H and HR. So this is cis product and this is a trans product. That means when we use, let's represent it like this. Okay, when we use a triplet carbene, then a cis product as well as a trans product is formed when carbene reacts with a carbon-carbon double bond. So that is the difference. Okay, that's how we can know what kind of carbene is there. If it is a singlet carbene, then it will only form one product. But if it is triplet carbene, then it will form two products. Okay, both of them. Now there is one more reaction that is very important in case of carbene. let's see that is important for examination as well, and a very simple reaction, dimerization reaction, that is called dimerization reaction. In dimerization reaction, what happens? Let's take a nitrogen like this, R and double electron plus, it will react with another nitrogen and it will merge and it will form R2N2. So this is a dimerization reaction. Okay, it will form a R2N2, and this is a very important reaction for your exam point of view as well. And the previous reaction, that is reaction of nitrogen with a double bond, that is also very important. I hope you understood everything about nitrogen. That's all in this video. If you like the video, please share this video as much as you can. And thank you for watching the video.